तरह की घटना इन लोगों ने की है, जिस तरह से इन्होंने हत्याएं मानवता रहित होकर के की है, तो मेरे बेटे की भी जान चली जाती। और मुझे लगता है कि इनकी साजिश यही थी, शायद उन्होंने जो मेरी गाड़ी कार्यकर्ताओं को लेके जा रही थी उसको देख करके ही समझा हो कि मेरा बेटा इसमें है, तो उसकी हत्या करने के लिए भी हमला ये हो सकता है।
FIR बाप और बेटे पर, दोनों पे। ये पहला वो होगा कि देश के होम मिनिस्टर पे FIR दर्ज हुई हो।
People who have been killed over there and who were really murdered by the union minister's son. He had mowed them down with his car.
कल जो हुआ है हादसा, उससे पूरे देश के किसानों के मन में बहुत गुस्सा है।
Good evening, everyone. I'm Shivani Gupta. Thanks a lot for staying with us. Two FIRs have now been filed in the Lakhimpur violence case. One against the alleged mowing down of farmers, naming MOS home Ajay Mishra and son Ashish. Other by the latter side against the violence and lynching meted out by unidentified individuals that led to the death of the driver of one of the vehicles, two BJP workers and even a journalist. The Lakhimpur case will be the test case for whether, away from the lofty ideals propounded by all, justice is actually same for all. This is not the first time violence has broken out as part of farm laws agitation. But will an example finally be set? Or is it that if you're aggrieved for whatever reason, if you are an agitator on an issue, if you are a protester, you can do anything to anyone? First up, here is what both sides have said.
हमारे कार्यकर्ताओं की हत्या हुई है और जो वहां से जानकारियां मिल रही उनके आधार पर मैंने देखा है और जो वीडियो में स्पष्ट है कि कुछ लोग ऐसे मार रहे हैं, गाड़ियों को जला रहे हैं और उसके साथ साथ कुछ लोग ऐसे जिनकी हत्या हो गई है उनको पीट पीट कर ये भी कह रहे हैं कि तुम मंत्री जी का नाम लो, ये कहो कि उन्होंने कुचलने के लिए कहा, मेरे बेटे की भी जान चली जाती। और मुझे लगता है कि इनकी साजिश यही थी।
FIR बाप और बेटे पर, दोनों पे। ये पहला वो होगा कि देश के होम मिनिस्टर पे FIR दर्ज हुई हो।
Now, the UP government has already announced compensation for all dead and for injured, along with a judicial inquiry, and that action against the minister and his son will be taken. In fact, they have now guaranteed to the protesting farmer unions that they will make arrests within 8 days.
Sir, अभी जो समझौता हुआ है, किन-किन बातों पर सहमत बनी है?
मुख्यतः पांच बिंदु डिस्कस हुए हैं। इसमें प्रथम बिंदु है कि जो प्रत्येक मृतक हैं उनको 45 लाख रुपए का मुआवजा तथा जो घायल व्यक्ति है उसको 10 लाख का मुआवजा तथा इस पूरे प्रकरण की एक रिटायर्ड हाई कोर्ट जज के द्वारा जुडिशियल इंक्वायरी तथा जो मृतक हैं उनके एक व्यक्ति को उसकी योग्यता के हिसाब से स्थानीय लेवल पे एक नौकरी प्रदान की जाएगी तथा शासन के द्वारा कल ही स्पष्ट किया जा चुका था कि इसमें जो भी व्यक्ति दोषी हैं उनके विरुद्ध कड़ी कार्रवाई की जाएगी।
The opposition meanwhile has been up in arms demanding justice for the four dead farmers. The question is, why not ask and fight for justice for all? Are those lynched to be forgotten on the altar of politics and identity? Do their lives not matter?
गृह राज्य मंत्री का इस्तीफा होना चाहिए और जो दोषी हैं उनको 300 दिनों में जेल भेजना थी, ये सरकार कब करेगी, ये सबसे बड़ा सवाल है।
जब तक रगा च लहू है, जिस्म च जान है, एक काले कानून पंजाब च लागू नहीं होने देंगे।
आई स्ट्रांगली कंडम दिस इंसिडेंट इन ऑल द स्ट्रांगेस्ट टर्म्स। आदित्यनाथ हैज नो मॉरल राइट टू स्टे इन ऑफिस।
दे वांट टू स्टॉप द डेमोक्रेसी। Only the autocracy is going on. We condemn this.
So the question we ask this evening, if there have been four that have been allegedly run over, four that have been allegedly lynched, in fact those videos caught on camera, shouldn't justice be equal for all? Isn't everybody equal before the law? Let me go across to our guest joining us, Dr. Kaushal K. Mishra, spokesperson of the BJP, Adil Singh Boparai, spokesperson Congress Party, Tushar Gupta, senior editor Swarajya Magazine, and Arvind Kumar Jain, former DGP Uttar Pradesh, is joining us. Let me in fact first go across to Arvind Kumar Jain himself. Is it not odd that the UP police was sitting with the farmer unions, those who are protesting, you know, whose own conduct is under scanner right now and deciding as to what should happen as far as this probe is concerned? I mean, are the farmer unions going to decide what process is going to be followed, what is going to be done in a case?
Had not committed any crime. There is absolutely no illegality in UP police sitting with the farmers' unions. They are not enemies. They are not enemies, and we have to keep in mind that we have to maintain, police has to maintain law and order. And all the groups, all the pressure groups should be kept in good humor. There is no harm in it. But once they have taken the law in their hands, I think action will be taken against those also who are seen lynching people, who are seen killing mercilessly the occupants of the car of the minister. So action should be taken against against these people also. A very sad incident has occurred. It should be also be inquired as to what led to the accident. I am told that there was brick batting and the driver got panicky. So what exactly happened, I'm not aware of it, but it should be looked into on merit as to what led to the accident.
Yeah, of course, that will be part of the probe. And there is obviously no question if that is probed. But I'm trying to understand, you said something very interesting. All pressure groups should be kept in good humor. Let me go across to Adil Singh Buparai also on this. Adil, I can understand the demand for justice. But are pressure groups going to decide what way the justice is done, when, how? Everybody else who's not part of a pressure group, their lives don't matter? For example, in this case, politicians don't seem to be enraged that multiple people were lynched in cold blood. Looks like I've lost the link with Adil. Let me go across and take that question to Dr. Kaushal K. Mishra. Mr. Mishra? Is it the UP police's job to keep pressure groups in good humor?
No. If you see the whole incident, first of all, it's very unfortunate incident, and our government is very sympathetic to everybody, whether they are for protester or they are from one media person has died, few of our supporters have died.
They've not died, they've been
the
killed. There's a difference.
They have been killed.
Yes.
Because the investigation is still pending, and available videos are so conflicting that I am not an investigating agency and I cannot be surely said who is guilty and who is not guilty. And the same stand is of the government. Okay, government is not here to say somebody is guilty or somebody is not. Investigation probe has been ordered.
No, but that's my question. Then that's my central question.
Demand.
Why did the UP police, under pressure from one of the pressure groups, as has been said, in this case the farmers, lodge an FIR? Why did they not lodge an FIR on the lynching that has come to light on video?
Actually, this is because we are in the power and we are administrating the UP, so we cannot be the party. But you have to see the hypocritic face of the opposition leaders. You have find out the last many incidences of lynching. Every political party is coming forward for their own vote bank and their own politics. Whenever it suits, they bring the lynching in the issue. But in this particular lynching case, they are keeping silent. And that is the dual standard and dual face of the opposition. That is the clearly shown by the this incident.
Okay, so, let me take that to Adil. Adil is back with us.
Opposition party.
Yes, let me go across to the opposition party here. Adil, the central question that I was trying to ask you earlier also is that pressure groups aside, and pressure groups are to be kept in good humor to maintain law and order, that in itself is quite a damning situation in our country. But that aside, even if there are grievances, there are clearly grievances on all sides here. Four people have been mercilessly lynched to death. We don't know the sequence of events. We don't know exactly who's guilty for the sequence of events. But one thing is clear, that people were lynched in cold blood. Why is it that that is not even being condemned? Leave aside asking for justice for those individuals. Adil, can you hear me?
Shivani, I just heard your question and your presentation. One thing is very clear, that four farmers, four sons of the soil, have been mowed down by a BJP minister's son's cavalcade.
It's not clear. It hasn't been proven.
BJP minister's son's cavalcade.
It hasn't been proven.
It's still pending. Investigation is still pending.
Well, quite clearly, Shivani, you've taken a position, so be it. But I have something to say to the BJP and their extended ecosystem, that the BJP will not remain in power forever. That is the nature of democracy. They will be voted out of power. And when they're voted out of power, let me say this responsibly on behalf of the Congress Party, that all those responsible for atrocities on farmers, for demonizing farmers, for spreading misinformation, will be brought to justice and held accountable. At a time when a union minister's son should have been arrested, the intoxicated BJP government is arresting opposition leaders.
They're being detained, they're not exactly being arrested. But Adil, can I bring your attention back to the focus of this show?
I sound like a BJP spokesperson
to you all the time. Regardless, I'm going to ask you the questions that I'm going to ask you. I asked you the question, why is the lynching of these individuals, whether they were involved in the mowing down of the farmers or not, is to be proved. Why is that not even being condemned? Do you condemn it?
We condemn any form of violence.
Do you condemn this incident?
I think it'll be asking for too much from you to condemn mowing down of farmers. Quite clearly you've taken a position. But be that as it may, the BJP's wheels of arrogance.
No, I am no one to condemn or not condemn. You are the political opposition in Uttar Pradesh. You have condemned the killing or the mowing down of the farmers.
Not at all.
I am only asking you, is the similar condemnation going to go down for what has been caught on camera is cold-blooded lynching of individuals? Leave aside whether there was the driver of the cavalcade or not, whether they were BJP workers or not. Is that lynching to be condemned at least?
Children have been mowed down. Spare a thought for those mothers.
I do. I want justice for them. I'm only asking you, those who have been lynched, do they deserve justice equally or not?
Absolutely. Absolutely. The Congress Party, unlike the BJP cabal, does not believe in hypocrisy and selectivity.
But I didn't hear any of your leaders saying that this lynching was bad. This shouldn't have been done. Not a single opposition leader has said, don't take law and order into your hands. This isn't the first time that protests have turned violent.
You must ask your leader why Amit Mishra has not been arrested. You must ask this to your leader.
I am no one to interfere in the investigations. In fact, that's exactly the question that I'm raising. That let the investigations go on. Who are pressure groups to decide which way the police will act?
Shivani, are you a moderator?
An FIR has been registered. I am a moderator, but Adil, you have a problem as a political spokesperson. All you do is attack either the anchor or the media. What about your responsibility? What about the responsibility of protesters?
No. You are not letting me speak. Let me speak.
Go ahead.
Let me speak. The BJP's wheels of arrogance, Shivani, the BJP's wheels of arrogance are crushing Indian citizens. And let me make it extremely clear on the behalf of the Congress Party that there must be justice for all. At the same time, to detain opposition leaders is absolutely uncalled for.
Okay.
Is Uttar Pradesh an island in itself?
I'm happy you've now used the correct term. They've not been arrested, they've been detained. Let me go across to Tushar. The central point. Yes, Tushar, I'm coming to you, but let me ask the question.
Why this pretense?
Let me ask the question. Tushar, the question that I'm asking you, that everybody seems to understand, that you have to placate the farmer unions, you have to placate the anger that they have. And whatever the anger may be, whatever the causes may be, whether it's justified or not, I'm not getting into that. My question is that why is there not equal attention to four who have been lynched,
except
apart from those four who have been allegedly mowed down?
Adil, you need to keep quiet.
Adil, now you must let my other guests also speak.
Adil, quiet. Adil, we heard you. Please be quiet.
It is absolutely shocking for a news anchor to become an apologist for the BJP. Four people have been mowed down, Shivani, for heaven's sake.
Adil, you please mind your own business and mind what you need to say. Control yourself. Tushar.
Shivani,
absolutely
uncalled
for.
Sometimes I start feeling stupid as a taxpayer. Sometimes. And today when I heard the honorable speaker here from the UP police saying we have to keep them in good humor, I honestly felt stupid as a taxpayer because the farmers here are not paying any tax. Rakesh Tikait wants to rip off whatever taxpayer money there is to have MSP on all the crops that are grown under the sun. So that was one point where I really felt stupid as a taxpayer. But coming to the larger picture, firstly, we have seen enough videos of what was going on. We have seen the video of the unfortunate driver who was killed, who did not die of an accident, who was killed by the protesters. I won't even call them farmers. We heard the audio which said in Punjabi that kill them all. It was in Punjabi. It was very clear. I come from the state. I understand Punjabi. Now, there is a line that needs to be drawn. This is enough. All the political parties are very quick to rush to UP, to Lakhimpur, to see, oh, what happened? Four people were mowed down. There were four other people who were killed. If you're so genuinely interested in the cause, go for all the eight people. Come for all the eight people. Say, how can the BJP workers be killed like that? How can that innocent driver who might have been affiliated to any party in his personal personal life be killed like that? How can the farmers indulge in violence like that? These politicians, from Priyanka Gandhi to Rahul Gandhi to Akhilesh Yadav,
not interrupted once.
Adil, hold on. Where were these people?
No, this is not a new. I'm just saying, this is your show.
When farmers went on a rampage in Delhi,
it is your show.
Adil, hold on. Shivani, where were these politicians when Delhi police officials were beaten? Beaten back and blue on the red. Where were these politicians?
Shivani will not have a debate on that. She will not ask you a question. Why did Manohar Lal Khattar incite violence? Why did he make calling people to pick up the lathis? Shivani will not ask you that question. And
Adil is obsessed with greed.
This is the irony of New India. This is the irony of the media.
What was Captain Amrinder Singh doing?
It is BJP media versus the farmers.
Adil, what was Captain Amrinder Singh doing last year when he was telling the farmers to go crowd at Singhu? What was Charanjit Singh Channi doing at his first press conference when he was in Talikunum Bapis? Don't they realize that they already... No, Adil, I'll put this
Shivani
question to you.
Shivani is sitting chief minister.
No. Adil, you are inciting, a spokesperson of the Congress.
People to, to resort to violence. Please ask him that question. I'm sure you must have seen that video.
Adil, you are a spokesperson of the Congress, right?
It is unfortunate.
Right?
That's all I have to say.
Yeah. It's unfortunate.
Jawan, Jai Kisan is just a hollow slogan for you all. Let me come in. I'm really heartbroken.
One second.
He's talking about Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. My question is, Adil, you may like it or not like it, but you don't need to lose your mental balance. My question is also equally justified. My question, Tushar, one second. Don't talk at the same time because neither of you is audible. My question is also equally justified. The question that I'm asking on the Lakhimpur incident today, this evening on the show, is whether there will be justice for all. We believe in justice for all. But if one side is going to pressurize what is going to happen in an investigation before that investigation has happened, then that is there is a question to be asked. One second, let me go across. But let me go across to. Okay, Adil, I'll give you the first opportunity. I am asking you a simple question. There is grievances on all sides. There is no denying that. Tomorrow, for example, farmers have taken law into their hands on January 26. A BJP lawmaker's clothes were torn off. He was harassed in the most, ugly fashion in public. By protesting, so-called protesting farmers. We've seen violence taking place in some other areas scattered across the country. Now, this has happened in another farmers' protest. Now, you may say that they are protesting and they have anger. I can understand all of that. Tomorrow, let's say, there is a resident of the national capital of Noida or of Gurgaon who's being harassed by these protesters blocking roads, whose business has tanked because he can't open his shop. He goes and takes law and order into his hands, whatever his... grievance may be. Will it be justified? Of course not. So now, pressure groups alone cannot decide what is okay as part of a protest. That's
your
a simple debate. The Supreme Court is also asking that same question.
By the way, you can see it post the debate. Now, please give me 60 seconds. Number one, Shivani, as we speak today, four farmers have been run over. This is an admitted fact. It is not a disputed fact. It is an admitted fact. By a BJP convoy, number one, it's a case of 302 murder. Number two, as we speak, no arrest has been made of any of those persons who ran over the farmers. Number three, the same Arun Kumar Mishra, whatever his name is, MOS home, a few days back, his video is on public domain, is inciting people and threatening farmers that we know how to teach you a lesson. Number four, just yesterday, Manohar Lal Khattar is asking his party members to arm groups, telling them to pick up lathis. This is not some ordinary farmer. This is a sitting chief minister who has taken an oath to uphold the constitution of India. Shivani, with utmost respect, you may have your political affiliation, but please understand.
Adil, this is getting a little old by you. I don't care what your opinion of me is. You've made your point. I will take your point on Manohar Lal Khattar to the BJP spokesperson. But at least answer the question I am asking you. You don't answer anything I'm asking you. Is everything justified in the name of protest? And you keep talking about the four farmers that have been mowed down allegedly. What about these other four individuals allegedly who've been lynched? Allegedly. At least mention allegedly them in the same sentence. Allegedly. Is that too much shocked to ask?
I am shocked. Allegedly.
You will be shocked perennially.
Farmers have been allegedly mowed down.
Yes, it hasn't been proven. It hasn't been proven. That's why there's an inquiry. Otherwise, you just hang people, no.
Why do you need a BJP?
You hang people, no, if you believe that it has been proven. There's been alleged mowing down of four people.
Alleged,
there's been alleged lynching of four people. If you don't like it, that's fine. But
shocking.
I have to say alleged. It hasn't been proven.
Are against the farmers of this country.
Mr. Mishra, please respond to the fact that your own minister, Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar, wanted vigilantism.
Listen, Shivani. When my friend Adil started his own statement in your first question, he said directly a political reply that BJP will never come to the politics. So their objective is different. They are not trying to help the farmer. They are just visualizing Mungeri Lal ke haseen sapne aur yahan pe hai Pappu ke haseen sapne. Sirf yahi dekhne ki koshish ho rahi hai.
No, I don't want to get into that. Mr. Mishra, I am in the final 2 minutes of the show. Can I just ask you point blank? Will your government ensure that there is justice for everyone? Or are you also going to be pressurized into delivering justice in one way or another?
It's 100% promise. It's Yogi ji government. You will find 100% justice will be delivered and guilty will be behind the bar. It may be, it is investigation is on all the demands of farmers, all the demands of farmers.
It's a joke.
All the demands are for all the... Adil, this is
Adil,
not the way how to discuss.
Please don't talk over others.
Adil,
let him speak
Adil
now.
Adil, behave like a spokesperson. Adil,
no,
this is not the way.
Like a farmer.
Please listen.
I'm
all the demands, whatever is raised by the farmers, has been fulfilled.
Not a single
There is a judicial inquiring. There is FIR registered. It has been promised that within eight days, guilty will be
matter.
Get arrested.
Everybody is talking about the guilty of those who mowed down the farmers. I am coming back to my question, Mr. Mishra. What about those who've been lynched? You've not promised arrest for them. They don't deserve justice.
Can I answer this?
Shivani, 100%.
You've not
Shivani,
promised
100%
it.
They will be behind the bar.
Okay, Mr. Jain, I have 30 seconds for you.
Whosoever is guilty.
Mr. Jain, 30 seconds for you.
Yeah, I'm saying that all the FIRs are being lodged. All the lynching cases, they are being lodged. And very stern action is going to be taken against all those people who have lynched four people, which has led to death of one journalist also. So it is not like this that only action will be taken against BJP people. They are going to take drastic action against people.
No, but the police did not give assurances to the other side. That's my question. Should police be giving assurances to one aggrieved side? Anyways, I've run out of time. I do thank all of our guests for joining us. The fallout of the Lakhimpur violence continues to be our top focus. Of course, there's politics being played out on it. But as is the central focus of this show, what about justice for all? It cannot be one-sided, sympathy or justice, because 8 people have lost their lives. Thanks a lot for watching.